This is your News Source Evening Bulletin for today, Monday, the 30th day of September in the year 2019. Here's what we're tracking tonight. The Guyana Elections Commission has made a correction to its order for the claims and objections period, deleting the requirement for already registered persons to visit registration centers to verify their registration. That requirement created a furore over the weekend following the initial order published by the Elections Commission. Opposition nominated member of the Elections Commission, Sais Kunraj, in a post on his Facebook page today, said he was sent an updated order by the chief elections officer and the updated order does not have the requirement for already registered persons to visit registration offices. Kunraj had raised a concern on Friday, moments after the Elections Commission issued a statement. He said that was the first time he was hearing of the requirement and it was not discussed by the commission. The Guyana Elections Commission did not offer any immediate clarification on the issue. It was felt that a requirement would have affected persons who are out of the country or who may be out of their living area, and those elderly citizens who may not be able to move around. The claims and objections period begins tomorrow. Meanwhile, with the claims and objections period set to begin tomorrow, the Guyana Elections Commission has revealed that a preliminary voters list will contain the names of 646,625 persons. The figure was pulled from the original National Register of Registrants. And according to GCOM's Public Relations Officer Yolanda Ward, the preliminary list of electors that will appear from tomorrow will not include the names of new registrants from the recently aborted house-to-house registration exercise. She said she will be able to offer better guidance on the issue after tomorrow's statutory meeting of the Guyana Elections Commission. Ward, however, stated that the new names from the house-to-house registration will eventually be merged with the other data. The People's National Congress has been encouraging citizens who did not get registered during the house-to-house registration exercise to ensure they get registered during the claims and objections period. More news coming up in just a moment.
All across our nation, Guyana, we see it in your lives. The future is growing even stronger. GPTI. All eyes on Guyana skies as the voices of our people rise. Sing it, GBTI. Guyana's pride is in your eyes. GBTI. We see Guyana through your eyes.
Experience bliss in an exclusive atmosphere as Universe Boss Chris Gayle celebrates his 40th birthday in Guyana.
Batman out on stunting. Chris Gayle can't take like dumpling.
40 Shades of Gayle featuring Kes the Band live and in concert. At the Arthur Chung Conference Center on Saturday, 5th October. Bird tickets $3,000, general $4,000, stage front $10,000. 40 Shades of Gayle. Party with the Universe Boss Chris Gayle and a star-studded cast of international cricketers. 40 Shades of Gayle, featuring Kes the Band live and in concert at the Arthur Chung Conference Center on Saturday, 5th October.
Thank you. You heard right. Fuel up at Guy Oil $5,000 or more and enter to win. Tune in to Jumpstart on 94.1 FM Monday and Friday to receive your call to win big. Check Facebook for participating locations and more details.
To get your fuel system, boy. High mileage and performance, boy. Fuel it up and win.
Welcome back. A number of government departments and agencies are getting set to increase their response to those flooded communities as more floodwaters could be on the way. According to a statement from the Ministry of Public Infrastructure, the spring tides will continue until the 2nd of October. That's this Wednesday. The Ministry's Sea and River Defense Department is currently assessing the impacts of the spring tides on the sea and river defense infrastructure and affected communities in various locations along the coast. Chief Sea and River Defense Officer Kevin Samad has reported that technical teams from the various Sea Defense District offices have been monitoring vulnerable stretches of sea defense impacted by the spring tide, and measures are being taken to minimize flood impacts where this is achievable in the immediate circumstances. The current spring tides have been described by the Civil Defense Commission as unprecedented. It is one of the highest tides recorded for this year. Based on the published tide tables, high tide levels in excess of 3.2 meters above chart datum were experienced, with a maximum high tide level of 3.36 meters above chart datum on September 29, 2019. Several areas have experienced mild to severe flooding due to overtopping of revetments, seawalls, and earthen embankments in locations in regions 2, 3, 4, and 6. With regard to the measures being taken to minimize the impact of the current spring tide, the Chief Sea and River Defense Officer indicated the Sea and River Defense Force account units have been working to heighten vulnerable sections of earthen embankment and reinforce stretches of revetment and seawalls to minimize the extent of the overtopping. And with above normal high tide warnings to remain in place for the next 2 days, residents who have been affected by floodwaters are bracing themselves for even more discomfort. Several West Coast Demerara villages have been inundated with floodwaters as a result of the overtopping of the sea and river defenses. When the high tide goes out, residents have been left with flooded homes and yards. That water leaves nothing but mud when it recedes. News source visited some of the affected areas today, and the residents complained that the situation has left them in shock since it is nothing like they have ever seen before.
Well, yeah, it happened from since Friday, Friday morning, right? And the water flood till up to the door. Oh, Lord, the waves are high. High.
Have you experienced anything like that before?
No, it's the first time. First time I experienced that.
The water is the high tide and the breeze, and then the water is overcapping over the wall. Flood out the whole place. You can see the place condition over there.
How high did it fall?
So water come high.
Have you ever been affected before like this?
No. This is the first. We get flood and thing normal, but this is the first time we get so big.
Some of the residents also explained that their livelihood is also under threat, especially for those who are involved in the livestock industry.
I hear the chicken them hollering. They will come downstairs. Most of them is drowned already. And I get a safe couple. This is the smile on them, and I have to put them in the pen there. And so I save this couple here. Some people come and then give bleach, soap powder, hand gloves, just to clean up the place.
The Civil Defense Commission is leading the relief efforts, even as the Public Infrastructure Ministry carries out works to reinforce the sea and river defenses. Let's tell you now that days after the International Court of Justice announced that it will be hearing arguments on whether it has jurisdiction to hear the border row case between Guyana and Venezuela, the Foreign Affairs Minister of Guyana has taken Guyana's position to the United Nations. Delivering a statement on Saturday to the UN General Assembly in New York, Foreign Minister Dr. Karen Cummings raised the issue of Venezuela not wanting to participate in the case before the ICJ. She reminded that Guyana earlier warned about Venezuela's position on the International Court of Justice hearing the matter, even after it was transferred to the court by the Secretary General of the United Nations.
It was a decision binding on Venezuela, but we warned of Venezuela's unwillingness to participate in the proceedings. A year later, that warning is fulfilled. As we heard yesterday, Venezuela's unwillingness to be involved in a judicial resolution. It has hardened into refusal to pursue the path of peace through respect for the rule of law. Guyana has placed its fate in the world's highest court, and it will continue to do so.
Guyana is seeking to obtain a final and binding judgment from the court that the 1899 arbitral award, which established the location of the land boundary between then British Guyana and Venezuela, remains valid and binding, and that Guyana's Essequibo region belongs to Guyana and not Venezuela. Venezuela has claimed in a letter to the court that the Secretary General exceeded his authority under the Geneva Agreement, and that the court therefore lacks jurisdiction to adjudicate Guyana's lawsuit. Venezuela has indicated that it will not participate in the proceedings. The Foreign Affairs Ministry said on the well-established judicial precedent, the court will proceed to decide if it has jurisdiction over Guyana's claims, irrespective of whether or not Venezuela participates in the proceedings. In the field of education, President David Granger this morning used the Education Month rally and the exhibition to sell his government's improvements in the education sector. The president told the hundreds of teachers and students gathered at Durban Park that his government will continue to make their lives better. He said more money is being pumped into the education sector, and that is something he intends to continue.
And we will do everything possible to make the teaching profession one of the best professions to enter in this country. And that's why the teachers and the trainees at the Department of College of Education know that the stipends have been increased from what it was before 2015. And we will be increased again next year. This year, the stipends increased by 6% from what it was before 2015. Teacher salary, the lowest paid teacher, is now getting more than 45% than he was getting in 2015.
President Granger said the government will also continue a number of initiatives to support the nation's students and assist in their development. He said the National Decade of Development will focus on that.
Many of you sitting here today, students and teachers, will be the beneficiaries of that decade of development. 10 years from now, your lives will be transformed because you will be exposed to the best education system that this country could afford. You, the students of Guyana, are the best investment that we could make.
Education Month activities wrapped up today. A number of events were hosted across the country during the past month to highlight education in Guyana. Across the Region is coming up next.
We are legions of men standing strong, but never too proud to stoop and help someone. We must send a clear signal to all. Do right. Walk in upright ways. Knowing that's what being a man is all about. And everywhere. That things will only get worse when good men do nothing. Stand strong. Be the one to live right.
Tired of long lines? Register with MyGTT at mygtt.co.gy. That's mygtt.co.gy to view and pay your bills from anywhere. Enter to win an Amazon gift card worth $25 or a bounty voucher worth 5,000 Guyana dollars when you sign up today. GTT, do more.
Lights, camera, action. The stars are here again.
Friday, October 4th at Palm Court.
It's the annual champion party.
Featuring the champion himself,
DJ Bravo.
Introducing the Caribbean's new pop sensation,
Ariella Alexa.
A full practice session
with GBM Neutron.
Music by Trinidad's sexiest DJ,
DJ Anna,
along with the Boom DJs, Gully Raz,
Selector Diamond,
DJ Aquilo,
and DJ Hudson.
Champion Party,
Friday, October 4th at Palm Court.
Securing the best healthcare facility for you and your family is important. At Balmansing Hospital, we take pride in giving you the best healthcare at unbeatable prices. We offer a 24-hour emergency care, a well-equipped ambulance, the best group of international doctors. Whatever your medical needs are, we are here to make sure you're taken care of like family. From eye care to dental service, the best, most experienced gynecologist, pediatric care, skin care, well-trained radiologist, and a trauma center. Our goal is to get you healthy so you can live a healthier life. Balwant Singh Hospital, caring for you and your family by offering healthcare at unbeatable prices. Live, love, and enjoy life. Call 226-4279 or visit us at 314 East Street, Georgetown. Balwant Singh, best healthcare at unbeatable prices.
Across the region right now, Caribbean Airlines has announced a new promotion called Caribbean Layaway, an interest-free layaway plan, which allows passengers traveling within a 2 to 6 month period the opportunity to pay for their flights on a phased basis. It means passengers can now hold a reservation with a 25% deposit. Customers would have to pay the balance at the later specified date. The airline announced the promotion on its website today. The option applies to all flights originating in Guyana to all Caribbean Airlines destinations and all flights originating in Trinidad to New York. The airline said it would continue to add routes to this offer. The offer is not available on the company's website, but can be accessed at the ticket offices in Port of Spain and in Guyana. About 200 Bolivians are taking part in a protest march to demand more action be taken to stop fires that have ravaged their area. They are urging the President Evo Morales to declare a national emergency after blazes destroyed large areas of forest as well as ranch land and farms, leaving many people destitute. President Evo Morales has welcomed international aid but has stopped short of declaring a national emergency. Earlier this month, a Russian military plane capable of dropping large amounts of water on the fires arrived in Bolivia, and firefighters from Argentina have also been helping with the firefighting efforts. And finally tonight, international news. More than 100 people have died due to flooding caused by heavy rains in the Indian states of Uttar Pradesh and Bihar, officials have confirmed. Dramatic images of the impact of flood water on urban life have been coming out of the affected areas. Railway traffic, vehicular movement, healthcare services, schools, and power company and supply have been disrupted in both states, officials have said. An Uttar Pradesh government report said 93 people have died since Thursday. In eastern Uttar Pradesh, flooding caused officials to relocate more than 500 prisoners to other prisons after water entered three buildings. The additional district magistrate told reporters that officials were awaiting permission to move all of the prison's 850 inmates. The death toll in Bihar is 29, according to the State Disaster Management Authority. The impact in its main city has been grabbing headlines. And that's your News Source Evening Bulletin for tonight. I'm Gordon Mosley reporting.